YouTube world. This is going to be my first book review video. Sorry, I looked like crap. I don't care. And that book review is going to be Over, Wither by Lauren DeStefano. And I'm going to tell you what I think of it. Here we go. Here is your synopsis. Thanks to modern science, every newborn has become a ticking genetic time bomb. Males only live to age 25, and females only live to age 20. In this bleak landscape, young girls are kidnapped and forced into polygamous marriages to keep the population from dying out. When 16-year-old Ryan Ellery is taken by the Gatherers to become a bride, she enters a world of wealth and privilege. Despite her husband Lyndon's genuine love for her, and a tenuous trust among her sister wives, Ryan has one purpose: to escape, to find her twin brother, and go home. But Ryan has more to contend with than losing her freedom. Lyndon's eccentric father is bent on finding an antidote to the genetic virus that is getting closer to taking his son, even if it means collecting corpses in order to test his experiments. With the help of Gabriel, a servant she is growing dangerously attracted to, Ryan attempts to break free in the limited time she has left. There's your synopsis. In the beginning of this book, Ryan, the main character, is captured by these people selling her into a polygamous marriage, and that's basically your setup. So the plot for Wither was, it was okay. Not much happens, actually, but it kept my attention pretty much the entire time. I was hardly ever bored. There were a few slow parts, but not really enough to deter me from finishing the book. The idea of having polygamous marriages in the future is kind of far-fetched for me, but Lauren DeStefano really made it work here and really made her world come out and come alive. She did a very good job of making me believe that this could actually happen, and it would be very, very scary if this actually happened. The plot for Wither, basically you saw the premise was the polygamous marriage, a dystopian kind of future in which females, because of some genetic engineering, only live to age 20, males live to age 25, and that's pretty original as far as I'm concerned. There were some draggy parts, but I really enjoyed the whole book. I mean, there wasn't a part where I was like, oh my gosh, I have to put this down now because I'm so bored. I kept reading, and I read it within like 2 or 3 days, which is really fast for me. While some of the ideas don't quite make sense with the genetic stuff, like, you know, why in the world do they die at age 20? Exactly. Why in the world do they die at age 25? I mean, what makes those facts facts? I need some science behind it. But other than that, it didn't really bother me. So, good plot. The prose in this book is very beautiful, very beautifully written. The descriptions are great. I'm a huge fan of beautiful descriptions and settings. The dialogue in this book is very natural. I feel it fits the dystopian time very well. It characterizes very well for all of the characters, for Ryan especially, and for Lyndon especially, and for the younger sister wife, Cecily. You'll learn a lot about her. The dialogue does a very good job of characterizing everyone and the way it's described. Very real, very easy to follow, very easy to believe. The overall tone this book gives off is very dark, very chaotic, very confused, indecisive, which is basically the whole theme of the book is indecision. And it's conveyed very well. Ryan is often torn between her life of wealth now, even living in the polygamous marriage and living in what she doesn't believe in, and going back to the way things were when she was struggling with her twin brother. And it really puts things into perspective, her being torn between this conflict. I also really like the fact that this book gives off a very Victorian vibe. Despite the fact it's a future novel, it's not at all, like I read Matched a few weeks ago, and it was very one of those futures that you imagine, you know, on TV. Very clean, clean lines, everybody's wearing almost the same thing, things like that. This had a very old vibe for a dystopian future novel. It was very Victorian in all of the dress descriptions and the descriptions of the house and the people. Very beautiful, very nostalgic. Made me want to go read some historical fiction, and I really loved DeStefano's ability to pull the Victorian and the old and combine it with the new and chaotic and the disgusting future she's created here. Last and certainly not least, characterization is probably this book's strongest point. While not every character is completely fleshed all the way, 90% of them are. For me, Ryan is a little less characterized than everybody else, but you still get a good sense of who she is. She's a stronger female character than I've seen recently in young adult. And so I really enjoyed that. And she keeps her mind on her focus of getting back to her brother and escaping this future. But at the same time, you know, anyone who's in the situation of going from a life of poverty into a life of wealth, despite the fact of the circumstances it's under, anyone would be torn between the two. And so I can really feel her conflict, and I really enjoy that. Jenna, the sister, one of the sister wives, the older one, she was well characterized, and I love the fact that we don't just completely dive into these characters. We don't know them instantly. It takes a while for us to get to know them, and we're slowly, slowly getting a sense of who they are, like you do in real life. You don't know someone from a first impression, usually. Usually, if you become friends with them, or if you start to know them as an enemy, you learn more about them as you go on, and your perceptions and impressions change. And that's really how each character was presented here, and I really liked that. It made it feel very, very real. Jenna is a good girl, but she's just accepted her fate. Cecily is so annoying, the younger sister wife, but she has a good heart behind her. And you learn all this in time. And I love all the backstory you get behind each character. I love character backstories so much. And they're so interesting and enjoyable to read. And some of the things in here are very horrifying, but just all the characters captivated me. Now, the character I liked the most actually isn't Gabriel, the servant she falls dangerously close to or whatever. Gabriel, I didn't get much of a sense of who he is, in all honesty. I was very indifferent about Gabriel. I don't know if that's my fault or if anybody else feels that way, but the character I loved the most was actually Lyndon. I actually fell in love with Lyndon. And you know, that's weird to say because he's the one that Ryan is forced to marry along with Cecily and Jenna. And the premise for the whole story revolves around this. But he's not the antagonist, which, you know, I think is a great decision on DeStefano's part. You come to find, as you get to know him, while he's very sickly and kind of ill, he has a strong passion for what he does. And I love the way DeStefano describes Lyndon's passion, which is kind of like an architecture design sort of thing. The way she describes him and the way Ryan spends time with him and the genuine love he feels towards all of his wives. While the idea of polygamy doesn't sit right with me, the fact that he loves each and every one of them differently says so much about him. And I'm not, like, you know, glorifying polygamy or anything, but Lyndon's character was just very well done, and I was, if there were Team Gabriel, Team Lyndon, I would be on Team Lyndon, despite the fact that I hate the whole team thing. Vaughn is Lyndon's father. He's actually the main antagonist, and he is disgusting. He makes me cringe, and she did a good job, DeStefano did a good job in describing Vaughn and making him seem very creepy, but at the same time, very driven towards a goal. And you see his side of the story as well, despite the fact you may not agree with it. Now that I've kind of talked about the book, it's time for the rating. And honestly, I read this book so fast. It was such a surprise, and a welcome surprise at that. I'd been dragging through the last few books I'd been reading before this one. And this one, I just flew through, but at the same time, I wished I could savor it too, and I want to go back and read it again. It's been a long time since I've read a book, and then right after, I wanted to immediately read it again, except slower, so I could get every little detail and just emphasize about what I love about this book. There wasn't much to complain about for me, in all honesty. I'm not going to pick it. I don't like to pick at editing and, you know, execution and all things like that. I liked the story. It kept me entertained. There were some slow parts. Characterization for Gabriel could have been a little better, I feel. But in all honesty, I didn't have any huge problems with this book. Mainly things to talk about were good, were great even. So this is the first book in a long time that's kept me up all night, and I've thought about it since I stopped reading it quite a few times, so many times. It's inspired me to keep writing, and I love books that do that. So, because of that, Wither by Lauren DeStefano is going to get a 5 out of 5 stars from me. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next review. Bye!